In 3 months of COVID-19, the unemployment rate in the United States rose higher than it ever did during the Great Recession. According to the Department of Labor, over 30 million Americans found themselves out of work due to a situation beyond their control. Economists predict that the economic impact of COVID could last for decades to come. It's clearer than ever that the United States needs a safety net to protect American livelihoods in times of economic instability. One of the ideas we propose is the National Endowment for Prosperity, created by trade, natural resources, and government assets. The National Endowment for Prosperity would give every citizen an equal opportunity to share in national wealth building and help reduce the growing wealth inequality in the U.S. The endowment would be managed by a sovereign wealth fund, a tool that has already proven successful in supporting government operations all over the world. National endowments have achieved great success in countries as varied as Singapore, Canada, South Korea, and Norway, as well as in states like Alaska and Texas. There are many ways the National Endowment for Prosperity could be kickstarted in the United States. One way would be through bail-ins. Instead of bailing out troubled companies, the U.S. government would take an equity stake in the firm. This gives taxpayers a chance to share in the upside of recovery, rather than just taking on the risk of bailing out shaky firms. The government could also offer tax incentives to existing firms who transfer equity ownership to the National Endowment, or require new firms to grant the government a small equity share in order to incorporate. Another way would be to mandate that companies using intellectual property created on the basis of publicly funded research pay a fee or provide shares to the National Endowment. These are just a few of the many options. Once the National Endowment for Prosperity is established, it could be used and managed in a variety of ways. The endowment could follow Japan's lead, investing directly into the financial markets, or Singapore's, seeding new firms. It could operate as it does in Norway, taming inflation and managing a common asset. In Norway, those assets are oil and natural resources. In the United States, it would be our deep financial markets and dynamic economy, which draw in the world's capital. Regardless of the chosen path, it would be guided by a long-term investment strategy that would allow it to operate flexibly, yet remain accountable to Congress. As the National Endowment for Prosperity accumulated gains, they would be distributed in a variety of ways so that people would directly benefit from national wealth building. They could be used to fund a universal basic income system of consistent, individualized cash grants, similar to the Alaska Permanent Fund, which has been extremely popular for its success in decreasing inequality and encouraging entrepreneurship. Another alternative would be to establish a pre-distributionary universal basic capital program consisting of baby bonds and guaranteed high-yield savings accounts managed by a postal bank. These bonds or accounts would be awarded to each American at birth and paid off in adulthood. They could be used towards significant one-time expenses. A less direct but more straightforward alternative would be to supplement taxpayer support for public services like education, retirement programs, and medical care. Any of these approaches would have a significant effect on reducing wealth inequality in the United States by making workers less dependent on their incomes for necessary services and enabling them to save more of their earnings. The National Endowment for Prosperity is realistic and attainable. The idea has shown great success in a diverse range of countries around the world, and even within the U.S. on a smaller scale. It's time for every American to have an equal opportunity to share in the wealth that they help create.